Hey, welcome to another great hacker tutorial. Today we'll be taking a look at QuillBot. It's an AI that, in my opinion, it's not getting as much attention as it should. Like, everyone is talking about ChatGPT, but I think QuillBot is definitely an amazing complement that if you are using ChatGPT or any other AI to write your essays, then you should continue the writing process with QuillBot. And so, in short, if you still don't know what QuillBot is, let me show you. Now, in case you haven't heard about QuillBot before, it's an AI that you can use for paraphrasing. It's not like ChatGPT that you give it a prompt and the AI will write something for you. Here you just paste a text that you have. It can be either free from ChatGPT, like we are going to use now, or maybe any other source, and the AI will analyze it and will give you something different, new. It will change a few words, it will use synonyms, maybe it changed the order of the words, add a few things here and there, so it really looks like it's a different text. And in either case, you can use it and you will be evading plagiarism, which is the most important thing you need to do as a college student. But hey, let's take a look at how you can use QuillBot to write your essay. Well, as you see here, we have the prompt and everything that we got from ChatGPT on our last tutorial. You can go and check that out. And as you may know, ChatGPT is not always the best in terms of not so much accuracy, even though it's a problem, but more important on plagiarism. Sometimes it will kind of copy and paste something it took from another website, maybe change a few words here and there, but still, it's really important to check for plagiarism. And for that, in case you know that, hey, this section is 100% copied and pasted from another place, you can copy it. Let's copy this. We go to the paraphrasing tool here in QuillBot and we paste what we have now. Well, as you can see, QuillBot has a limited word count of 125, so we can't just copy and paste anything we want, but it's still worth it, especially considering that you can paste one paragraph at a time. After hitting on paraphrase, as you see, QuillBot will change a few things of the paragraph. For example, here you can see everything that's in orange are the words that were changed, everything that's underlined on yellow are the structural changes, and then words highlighted on light blue are these kind of longest unchanged words. If you give it and you don't like what you got, you just simply hit on rephrase and it will do. It will be pretty much the same, maybe a few other changes, but it won't make that much. So when you have it and you like it, like, hey, this is great, we can paste it and we go to the document and we have it here. It also including the in-text citation, so that's amazing. And that's pretty much how you can use it. Now, I mainly recommend using QuillBot with ChatGPT for these long sentences, because this way you know that you're not committing plagiarism. But another excellent way to use QuillBot is to use a source. For instance, in this example, we'll be using this article from ResearchGate. Of course, you can use whatever article or journal you need to use. So once we found what we want to include in our text as an in-text citation, we simply copied it, paste it here, and hit paraphrase. So we now have a new way to include this information in our essay without it being a direct citation. Now that we have both versions, we can go back to our document and edit them. This way we have the most important information we want to quote directly in our text, and also have the follow-up sentence that's paraphrased, so we don't need to worry about plagiarism at all. Yeah, it's great, but you need to go and repeat this process every time you want to use a direct citation or quote anything from any source. But still, it's a great tool. But in my opinion, one of the best features that QuillBot has is its summarizer. This tool is great when you have a source with a long paragraph that's really complex and you really need to break it down so you can then go and paste it into your text. So we go back to our original source and we copy the section that we need to summarize. In this case, we're going to go with the results. We paste it and now we need to edit it a bit because it has a word limit of 600 words. So we edit it, we get 585 words. We click on summarize and now we had 164 words with an overall overview of everything that we gave it at first. So now that we have this amazing summarized version, we can either A, we go to our document and we paste it and we ourselves find a way to include the in-text citations, or B, we can break it down into multiple paragraphs and give each of these to the paraphraser tool so we know we are not taking any risk on plagiarism. But let's say we are done with the process and we have all the information we needed from our source, now it's time to create it. So we can use QuillBot's citation generator, it's great. We go to the source, we copy the DOI, in this case because it's a journal, since there was a website, a book, you here can add it. We paste the DOI, click on cite, click here, and here we can choose the citation style. We here have the full citation, we simply copied it, and when it's time to include the very important reference list, well, not this. Now much better. Now I do need to say that I've been using QuillBot's free version and they have a premium plan with more features that doesn't have any word limit and lets you access all of their other tools, but in my opinion the free version is more than enough. We were able to use the paraphraser, the summarizer, then we also have the citation generator, we have the grammar checker, which is great, it works, it gets the job done. Here, let me show you. Let's use something that we got from ChatGPT's previous tutorial. Let's paste it. And as you see, grammar is great, there is nothing to correct, but all the sentences, all the styling suggestions, you need to go premium to actually access. You can use it to go and see that there are no grammar mistakes, spelling errors, formatting errors, but you know, if you are also looking for a styling suggestions, you won't find them here, unless of course you want to go and find the premium plan. But still, it's a very complete version that you can even integrate it into Google, into Word, you also have a translator, the grammar checker as I was saying before, it's great. And let's say you want to go ahead and pay for it because you don't have Grammarly as I have. Prices are not that expensive, maybe the monthly can be like, hey, maybe this is a bit, but if you want to go for the annual plan, you pay like $50 for the year. So if you know you're going to use QuillBot for the entire rest of the year, it can be worth your shot. You have any more things, you can go ahead and check it out. But still, this is how I like using QuillBot to write better essays. As you saw, you can use the paraphrasing and summarizing tool to really avoid any type of unwanted plagiarism and complement ChatGPT. And if you have already used QuillBot, let us know what was your experience, share your own tips if you have them, and let us know in the comments if there is any other tutorial you want us to take on next. Remember to subscribe to our channel and we'll see you next time.